So that is going to be, what I'm saying is the last word for the first presentation. I'm not against which I think you guys have been very much influenced by Saurashtra, because happening in Saurashtra is one of the people who I think the reason why you did not mention Sundar is that the reason that Adman Pokhar failed was the movement behind success of Saurashtra didn't even think that it was better than the government. I think that it's a wonderful thing. All I am posing to you is any about a year ago and start meeting your future manager for HR and go to the interview. Talking. I found that there is a lot of subjectivity, lack of objectivity in the way the performance and the impact of AMR programs are being discussed in literature. Now, if you may agree, you may not agree. I will show you what I mean. And then one thing I found was there is a group of people who said, great, which are the number works, so it's one of them for me. Nothing better than which are the number, and whatever. And then some people say, no, this is all rubbish, waste of money. You know, in this case I want to talk about it, deliciousness, these whatever. Yeah. So I found literature on both sides. And one thing as me as a researcher found was that both of them are not objective. I'm not saying they're right or wrong, but they're not objective. So what I'm going to talk about is in future if you guys are writing reports on manager of a HR, you may want to consider what I'm proposing here. What I'm proposing here is that we need to separate performance from impacts. I will explain this in more details. We need to separate performance from impacts because, I'll give you a reason, because where the management of the manager for HR can happen is in terms of performance. Therefore, performance should be studied. So let me go to this one. Some of you would recognize this diagram. This is from Gujarat, Gujarat program. So I think the literature on managing for HR lacks structure analysis. Performance and impact are intermingled, they mix up together. You have to remember the check dam or well or whatever, they are all engineering structures. When you design an engineering structure, there is a design criteria. It should hold certain amount of water, it should not silt up, it should get filled up, like you said, you have to fill up every 3, 4 days, once in a while or whatever. So there are certain design criteria people should look into the data I presented before for your own local situation, the property of the airport, the natural characteristics and all that. So when you design something, you expect it to perform to the design criteria. Now if you build this room to seat for 40 students, and then if you are seating only 30 students, then you are underperforming, you are over designing. On the other hand, if you have 50, 60 students, you need to accommodate it, you are under designing, and therefore, the next time you design, you will change the strategy. So, when you have a design criteria, it needs to be performed. If not, if it doesn't perform, then there is no impact. There is nothing to talk about. If you have a check dam which is sealed up, not allowed to go to the reach out, then the dam is as good as nothing. It didn't exist. Right? So the performance is a key thing. You need to make sure that it performs. There is a possibility that even if they perform, the impact is not necessarily guaranteed. That if you can perform, but it may not, the impact what you expect may not happen. So let's go into the detail. What is performance? Now you all have gone to universities, you have got degrees, honors, whatever. There was standard set. If you score 70%, you get a distinction. That is your performance chart, right? So the performance is something, it is an accomplishment again, preset, no standard. You have to meet this particular criteria, this particular standard in the performance. Otherwise you are underperforming. So in the construction of mass structures, in the pre-construction phase, we have to look into the soil, hydrology, topography, water availability, climate, the radiation in the all the factors you mentioned. Then you design the check dam, it's going to spill over, then you just have design a peak discharge, whether the maximum we could allow, what should be the spillway capacity, what should be the storage capacity. In the storage area, upstream of the dam, does it have sufficient infiltration capacity to get the water going, all those things have to be there. In the concept, there's no point you build a check dam in an area where you have a very highly placed soil. You never let the water go in, right? But if you have a fractured one, you will just quickly let it go in. Then, of course, once this is designed, then on the post-construction phase, again you have different type of performance capacity. Like I mentioned, I have designed the room for 40 students, I have 60 students, that means I have been under-designed. So that is the performance. So how from these check dam they fill well. It's an interesting performance capacity. How long the check dam remains full? And the December and the November, whatever, how long? These are important performance capacity related one. Now, if it is a large dam, we don't see that in Saurashtra, I have worked in some large dams in part of Baluchistan, huge dams, check dams, right? To stop all the flood in the coming year. This sort of thing. Now, when it happens in the flood, then it also destroys livelihood of people. It approves your villages, more than concerned, property concerned, damage, so. So, you need to kill that one. Then, incidents of sanitation. Many of these check dams which, that I have seen in Oman, I used to work in Oman also, people coming here, in Oman, Pakistan, these countries are very electric countries, which flash floods, like you said, in 3 days, you can fall over, you're coming, and then the sedimentation depth will be like 1 meter high for one event, just imagine, boom, it has opened the mountain, it has relocated, but close to the soil, right? So, sanitation might have happened. Then what the sanitation may be talk about, it is the silt from the soil layer above. Then what happens is the water moves through the soil, it also takes the clay particles through. So when you throw the clay particles through, the pore dam will get smaller, that means it will get clogged. So if the farm can go and do the silt, still no use, his soil is clogged, right? Water will not go. That's an area of clogging, damage occurs, and the maintenance required. How often do you have to desiltation?
Because I want to take off from the head, cut it from the cure it.
So now what the point I'm trying to give you is that when you design a mass structure, you have designed post, pre-designed their case, you have certain performance indicators, after that there are certain performance indicators. Fine. Now let's say what is an impact? Let's get the impact part. Impact is a sustainable change due to an intervention. That something changes and that is sustained. Now you have recharge movement, prosperity is coming, it should be sustained. If it disappears, then the intervention is not meaningful. So we are talking about impact means it's a sustainable change due to an intervention. It may occur in the lives of people belonging to a particular individual group or people on either side, positive or negative type of impact. So you get the difference between performance and impact. Performance is about the structure that we design and build and maintain. Impact is what will that structure do to other people, environment, whatever, in a sustainable manner. So I think this kind of distinction has not come across in the writing that we have seen. Now, when we talk about impact, then again you can go through different stages of impact. For example, if you have a check dam, the water stops, infiltrates. What happens? It recharges the water table. That is the primary impact. When it recharges the water table rises. That is the primary impact. Because the water was good quality, the quality has now come bigger, better. So that is the primary impact. So the primary impact of a MA program is definitely water table rise, there may be some quality change. Now this will happen, I don't need to take back to my previous presentation, only if you have the right soil that will cause the water to go down. The soil is going to hold the water up, then you won't see the impact. So the impact will depend on other factors, factors other than your mass structure itself. Factors other than the soil and the hydrogeology and all those things, factors other than the mass structure itself. And then of course in a groundwater situation, you can have regional flows. That is the concern Chunaraj talked about, that I am recharging somebody's benefiting all those things, right? So from the performance, we will expect a primary impact. Then we can another level, we could expect a secondary level of impact. Now that I have a water, what do I do with the water? Let's take the situation in Bihar where you have shallow water table, very shallow. It will make no difference to the farm, right? This productivity is always low. In Saurashtra, when the water will come, everyone is prospering. So making the water available does not mean that you have created a sustainable impact, you have created an impact in the water. That has nothing to do more than that. So what has to happen now is that secondary impact should come, the available water should become accessible water. That there should be electricity, pump, to pump the water, use it and all those things. So just by allowing the water in the aquifer without the enabling factor, it
may do no good, it may not do any good. Now, the second impact of MR, the positive one, is what you will often see is that area of cropping will increase.
Usually,
the cropping intensity will increase, crop yield will increase. People have more livestock carrying capacity. People will shift to high eating varieties. People will shift to vegetables, right? So those, all those things happen. Whatever is there, but then he is not going to grow vegetables. There is no market for it. You see, he is not going to do it just because there is water, right? So the secondary impacts of MA are the benefits you derive from the primary impacts of MA. Primary impacts are additional water, good quality drinking water. Secondary impact is, of course, what have got to be done with the output from it. Now, one of the things that is that you may have to have better quality of drinking water. Better quality of the energy use will be reduced because of the water level is using lesser energy. So, that is the secondary impact. Then, another level of impact will come, which is what we are all talking about. That is the change in, sorry, the second impact. Sorry, I was going to rush myself. Again, if you have a high yield, you must have a quality of seed, better labor, better energy level. All those things are important, right? Fine. Then what happens is that what we all would like to see happening is a change in livelihood. Income levels going up, children going to school, right? Better income. But that also requires another level of enabling conditions. For example, if you want to have potentially increase income, not only you have to produce, you will be able to sell it at the right price. Now if you drive around many of the regions these days, the one of the frustrating things you will see is some vegetables are just dumped on the street. These potatoes dumped on the street. Then you see too many parts of them these days. So there's so much to do, there's no to buy. Certain things are from harvested. There's no market for it, they are planted and sold. So that will depend on various conditions like markets. Value of the land may go up, children will go to schools and so forth and so forth. So what does this require? It requires another level of enablers. Directness of market, access to infrastructure, price guarantee and so forth. So if I may summarize, what I'm saying is that when we analyze the MA program, whether the retail movement here or wherever, we need to separate the performance of the our intervention from primary, secondary, tertiary impact when we start to analyze. Then we become very objective. You will see what enables them to produce better yield, better crop varieties and so forth. So in diagrammatic way, I can say, look, this is where we work on, that is the performance of many factors for each child, there are some primary impacts comes up, if enabling conditions are right, secondary impacts comes up, if different types of enabling conditions are there, and the tertiary impacts what we see for comes up if inner level of tertiary impacts are there. So, additional separating enabling conditions would be there. Now, going back to my initial criticism that the MA literature that we find are not going through, they, I reviewed some of them. And so, some of the reports last year or so, important parts, I was trying to see whether you would talk, who's talking about, not necessarily like I put my performance here, primary, secondary, tertiary, who's at least talking about some of the primary impacts. So, for example, this is a report from Agarsha ownership. There is no talk about percentage of fill, there is nothing about it, there is nothing about infiltration, nothing about dental. In the same thing, the open trap, there was a talk about percentage of fill. No. So what is missing in these reports most of the time is the performance of the structures themselves. What they have is various levels of primary, secondary and tertiary impacts. They talk about, yes, there was switch out, both level came up, both column came up, whether the body has changed or not changed, primary part, then they go to the secondary part of it, where the pressure is going up, go to more supply and so forth, and so on. And then I also did more with you, another 3 more, including the group of domains were supposed to present to me, and it's changing. But again, you see, there's a lot of rows, right? So, if you are doing a review in the future or assessing a program, bring some structure to this one. That's what I'm saying. And why I'm saying this is that going back to our hydrogeology input and background and so forth, what we can really improve it is to change performance. If the check dam is filling up, then we can recommend the government or we can recommend the farm to reset it. If the clogging is taking place, we can recommend the farm to handle it, seal it, to loosen the soil, to absorb it and so forth. Anyway, that's what I want to share with you.
This is one of the check plans, one of the largest check plans I have ever seen in my life. This is a dollar check plan. Look at the size of the hand itself, you can just walk through. So ours, it's all silver dark. Right? So the performance is zero. So you don't expect any more impact from it. Yeah? But then if you were able to, and we have been monitoring this one, we will keep on maintaining that, then you could expect, you are expecting to find this again, based on the difference. That's all I want to say. Thank you very much. We just never do the feedback, so the goal is very rarely is being used, and nobody really pays attention to the management side of it, the performance side of it. I think the point I'm going to make is that if you separate these two and concentrate on the performance, then you can influence the entire performance of your structures continuously. So in future, if you are going to recharge program, keep this in mind. Some way or another, you look at this performance of the structure, so that is your objective. All of your done is just a natural recharge in your case. By intervening, by increasing the recharge. By, I don't know what percent, increasing the recharge. So then,
actually what you are saying is you are defining the primary impacts as recharge itself.
Yes.
Yes, because you are saying this is a managed act. It's a recharge program. Therefore, recharge is the primary impact. But in what we are talking about, in, for example, in MT or in Saraswara, it is not a managed act, it's a recharge program. They are not doing recharge to increase recharge. They are doing it, their primary objective is to increase agricultural growth. So they see primary impact as agriculture. And then see, okay, it happened because recharge was over.
See, you want to look at agricultural growth, like food chain. That's what you want. So I can give you fertilizer, I can give you free money, I can give you the farm. That is what I am going to do.
Right. Where you will, I think it was very good when you compared Bihar and Saraswara. Now in Bihar, the critical resource is not water. There is plenty of it. Critical is power or land. Right? In Saraswara, the critical resource, the key bottleneck is water.
Yeah.
It's not land, it's not fertilizer, everything else is available.
Yes.
But water is not there. Therefore, the intervention was to give water.
In Bihar, water is available, but not
excess.
But not excess. You do not invest on
one of the things.
Whereas here, you have rather than holding, rather which are they are going to invest on concepts of work, where they are not going to invest. You don't have to invest on it.
You are doing
it. Then comes the energy. So I have only half acre there. I don't want $2,000 to get a pump. You will give me anything. So
here we have 24 hour power supply. All of them have wells and pumps. The only thing missing is that we have wells.
So what was missing? See, I always talk people in all kinds of way. First thing you should be thinking about it, availability of water. We have water, otherwise you are not going to get it. Then is it accessible? Right? If you cannot access it, whatever the reason, you don't want to access it or you can't access it, it's no good. The third is what you achieve it.
Water balance. If you use it wisely, then you have less pressure to get
point. Exactly my point. Just because you have a mahata, just because the water has come up, if you make a mess of it, I assume it's in knowledge is not possible. The water is very deep, these are your pumping because they are full of electricity, and you run through a very dry soil profile, which is sand and water, everything is going back. So they're not doing anything. So, availability, achievement, sorry, availability, access, achievement. These are three.
Okay, so we move on to the next presentation.